Imagine for a moment that you're at the wheel, or should I say yoke, of your brand new Tesla Model S Plaid. And after being blown away by its acceleration, you decide to compete with the fastest cars in the world on a circuit. What would happen? Porsche 911 GT3 RS didn't even smell you. McLaren Senna. Ciao Bambino! And McLaren P1. Where did you think you were going? Okay, Alejandro, but this is a modified Tesla Model S and I am not a professional pilot like Randy Pobst. Really? I had mistaken you for the good old Randito. Well, let's go back to the beginning of this video. Imagine that you're at the wheel of your Tesla Model S Plaid. Oh, how fast your bird grows! And a supercar McLaren places next to you. So, what do you do? You press the gas a bit and let it eat up your electrons. The fan comes later, when you meet another sports car, the Mercedes GT43, and the driver decides to challenge you.
Hey, I'm gonna let y'all get a head start, okay? Don't go slow, okay?
And when the traffic light comes on, this happens.
Yeah.
Such is the impression that this new Tesla flagship makes on the other drivers that at the next traffic light, they tell you.
Amazing.
And after confess you that they're in love with your new baby, you decide to do something you thought you would have never done in your life. You put two complete strangers in your car, only to see their faces when you do this.
2, 1.
Wow.
Oh, it's not even blowing that hard.
What looks like a scene from The Hangover really happened to Roland Pollard, one of the lucky first owners of the world's fastest accelerating car. But these are mere amateurs. What do great automotive experts think about this car? Dan Neal is an automotive columnist for the Wall Street Journal and a former editor of the Los Angeles Times Auto Week and Car and Driver. Dan, which emotions does the new Tesla Model S Plaid arise on you? Between bouts of awe and car sickness, sharp curves next 22 miles, the Plaid sometimes had a melancholic effect on me. Man, nothing will ever feel fast again. Every piston-powered brake must now come with an asterisk. But Neil is not alone. Another of the great opinion references in the automotive world is Jason Cammisa. Jason is an award-winning motor journalist. He has spent more than a decade in such reputable magazines such as Automotive Magazine, Road and Track, and Motor Trend. Cammisa is also known for doing his own stunts for filming and for having a large collection of classic cars. After trying the Model S, Jason began his Instagram post with "Verdict Tesla Model S Plaid. Sorry, S-Class, your reign is over." And he ended up it, assuring this: "Judge as a chiron-beatingly fast, everyday luxury car, I must say I apologize to Rolls-Royce, Bentley, Bugatti, Mercedes-Benz, and every automaker on the planet. Good luck catching up. You'll need it. And at $130,000, nobody has a chance." So, at the center of these benefits and praises is it, the new Tesla engine with carbon sleeves. But what is it that makes it so special? In this video, we're going to see in detail the new engine of the Tesla Model S Plaid, the fastest engine in the world. Hi, this is Alejandro, and welcome to the best moment in history. And now you could help me so that this video is as spectacular as a car in which even strangers get on in it, if you like it when I say four, okay? One, two, and now. Many thanks.
I'm here with our road test editor, Erick ayapana. He's the man behind the wheel, and he just finished his run in the Model S Plaid. What'd you think?
It was completely insane, completely bonkers. The car did great. Usually with EVs in our past experience, they're usually one and done. That was absolutely not the case here. I probably did four or five runs, and yeah, the times were like spot on.
What the Motor Trend Test Drive editor comments is that this vehicle is not only the fastest in the world from 0 to 60 miles per hour and a quarter mile, but it also has a feature that no other electric car had ever had before, and is that these infernal accelerations can be replicated many times. Is this related to what we saw in the delivery event? Whereas the previous versions of this engine, when they reached a certain speed, lost power, the Model S Plaid does this. It increases its power until it reaches 1000 horsepower, and in an incredible way it maintains it until it reaches 200 miles per hour, and all this while using one single gear. But why? Why this motor not only accelerates more than any other in the world, but also maintains the power at different speeds and can also replicate this performance over and over and over again? To understand this, who better to explain it to us than him? James Douma, a Tesla investor and expert in neural networks, is an analytical mind that searches for data to decipher the truth. James, please, tell us the secret of this engine.
The reason they have to wrap carbon around that, right, is that to keep a motor, to keep an electric motor efficient, you need to minimize the air gap between the stator and the rotor, or the two moving parts, because air has 10,000 times the magnetic field resistance that the metal has, right? So even a tiny, tiny air gap dramatically reduces the efficiency of the motor. So you machine those things and you try to get that gap as tight as you can. The problem with motors that turn really fast, like when you're really getting up there in speed, is the rotor starts to expand. And in order, if you want to have a really high speed motor, you have to start with a much bigger gap. Because otherwise, if the rotor hits a stator, that's really bad, especially if it happens at 20,000 RPM. So, you know, so Tesla's fix was this was, let's find the strongest material in existence, and we'll squeeze that rotor down really, really tight so it can't get bigger. Even under 30,000 gravities of load, right, it won't get bigger. And that's just crazy. It's freaking awesome, and I want one.
Consequently, Tesla, in his rotors, instead of using the typical stainless steel encapsulation, has invented this carbon fiber system that nobody had ever made before. But how did they get it? Sometimes it takes an open mind to find the best solutions.
On the recruiting side, like, it doesn't matter if you know about batteries. If you come from any industry, you can do something fantastic in the work that we're doing. We talk to people from industries that you wouldn't imagine. Like, I talked to a guy who makes golf balls, and he has stuff which is really impactful for what we're doing. So, you know, if you're in any industry and you want to be, impactful here, like, come join us. It'd be great.
Golf balls! And how were these made in the past? Exactly. With a winded in a similar way to what the new Model S Plaid rotors with carbon sleeves do. Probably the inspiration for this new engine that reached up to 20,000 revolutions per minute came from these golf balls or from any other process or industry. That's not important. The fundamental thing here is that Tesla thinks of the best possible solution, not of what has been done so far. But one thing is to have this mentality, and another very different is to execute it. How does Tesla manage to continue innovating and taking its product beyond the limits reached until now? To find the answer to this question, I invite you to join me to a trip to the months prior to the launch of the Falcon 9 in the summer of 2010. Thomas Urbuchen, a Swiss-American astrophysicist, made a bet with his friends about the success of the first launch of the new rocket from a tiny startup called SpaceX. All the experts were sure that perhaps Elon Musk's company with the Falcon 1 had been able to send a small rocket into space, but that it wasn't going to be able to compete with the big boys of the industry, Lockheed Martin and Boeing. However, Surbuchen had an ace up his sleeve. This scientist had helped set up and lead a highly regarded graduate program in space engineering at the University of Michigan. And in the spring of 2010, when he was asked to write an article on talent development, he had to reflect. So, to draw conclusions, he decided to make a list of the 10 best students, and to his surprise, half of these didn't work for the leading companies in the industry, but they did at SpaceX, despite giving up a higher salary. The results blew his mind. They went there because they believed. Many of them took pay cuts, but they believed in the mission. The article was published just 2 months after the inaugural launch of the Falcon 9, and Elon Musk, upon reading it, decided to invite Surbuchen to the tour of SpaceX. Musk, after the typical pleasantries, became serious and asked his guest one question. One single question. Who were the other 5 students? It was at this precise moment that Surbuchen realized that this visit was not to show him the SpaceX facilities. I realized that all that invitation had not been about me. He wanted to recruit them. He wanted the other 5. Lady, gentleman, young lady, young gentleman, this talent that Elon Musk surrounds himself with is going to advance humanity as never before in history. Hi, this is Alejandro, and welcome to the best moment in history. What do you think of the engine of the new Tesla Model S Plaid? And most important, when will you invite me for a ride? You live in the best moment in history. Enjoy. If you have enjoyed this type of content, subscribe to this channel so you won't miss videos like this one. And I recommend you to watch this other video that I made just for you. Thank you very much from the heart.